Hello, check. All right, people, I believe we are premiering now. Welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu. If I'm audible and visible, please write you in the chat box. You know the drill. And today the class is not a live class. It's a recorded class. That's why it says premiere, right? So the thing is, on weekends, our classes are not live, are premiered. Today, we are going to discuss more about thermodynamics in this class. In the previous class, we have discussed the ideas of degrees of freedom, CP and CV in terms of degrees of freedom, and then we had done a very nice table at the end of the previous class, which we will start with. Yes, and after doing that, we will get into some further ideas about adiabatic processes. We will try to see how to, you know, calculate work done in the adiabatic reversible process for an ideal gas. Then we'll derive some generalization for an adiabatic process, and then further on we will try to compare reversible and irreversible work done. We'll start off with isothermal processes and then we'll try to discuss that for adiabatic processes as well. So I hope you're ready. First thing that we need to do right now is to revise that table that I had given you in the previous class. Yes, people, please make sure you're revising these classes before coming to the next one. Otherwise, you'll forget everything. Okay, so chalo, table kya tha? First, you had different types of gases. So kaisi gases thi? You had monoatomic gas. Yeah, please make this table if you haven't made it. Monoatomic gas, then you had diatomic, or essentially any linear gas. Yes, fine. And then finally you had your triatomic or polyatomic, essentially a gas that is non-linear. Okay, non-linear gases. So non-linear gases, bolata, their molecules are not linear. Their molecules are linear. Their molecules are not molecules. They're just atoms. Yeah, atoms are molecules themselves. So what were the things that we wrote over here? First, we'll write degrees of freedom. Then we'll write CV. Then we'll write CP. And finally, we'll write CP divided by CV. This is known as Poisson's ratio, also called gamma, Greek letter gamma. We'll see its application today when we discuss about the adiabatic generalizations. Fine. So first of all, let's write the degrees of freedom for a monoatomic gas. Only three translational degrees of freedom. So I'll write three over here. Three translational and two rotational for a linear gas. So total 5 degrees of freedom. Again, we are not considering the vibrational modes of freedom, and I've explained exactly why in the previous class. Take it. Triatomic, polyatomic, or non-linear, essentially, if your molecule is not linear, then it has three rotational, three translational degrees of freedom. So these are the degrees of freedom that we've got. Yes. CV, we had understood, was degrees of freedom divided by 2 into R. So I can write over here 3 by 2 R. This definitely and automatically becomes 5 by 2 R, because CP minus CV is equal to the universal gas constant R. So CP plus R is equal to CV. Then here will come 5 by 2 R. This will become 7 by 2 R. This is 6 by 2 R. You can write 3 R simply. And this becomes 8 by 2 R. You can simply write 4 R. You can write it however you want. Fine. And then CP by CV over here is 5 by 3. This is 7 by 5. And this is 4 by 3. So this is a table that we have to remember. Please keep this information in your mind. This information is going to be very, very useful in the calculations eventually, especially in your examinations. Fine? Theek hai ji? Chalo, badhiya.
revise it, note it down. So I have a beautiful looking image as well. You know, same thing. Yeah, nothing to worry about over here. This is how we represent Cp by Cv gamma. This is also known as the Poisson's ratio. Okay, not poison. Poisson, a scientist. Fine. So this is how we call it, Poisson's ratio, gamma, which is Cp upon Cv. Great. So now, my dear friends, let us try to tackle an adiabatic process. But before I get into that, I want to make a couple of announcements. One announcement is that we have an NCRT channel as well, Vedantu's NCRT channel on YouTube. And what we do over there is, for 11th and 12th class students, we solve NCRT. We give out chapters and their information based directly on the NCRT. So if you want to supplement your NCRT reading, then this is a very good channel. You can check out the link in the description box down below. Also, as you know, it takes a lot of dedication, it takes a lot of guidance to clear your dream examination, to get into your dream college. Yes, what you can do, what I would recommend you do if you are actually serious about this thing, is join Vedantu's Pro subscription. Yeah, vdnt.in/ytpro is the link. PHPRO is the discount code. This is in the description box down below. You'll have daily classes on Vedantu's patented platform. Yeah, EdTech mein, one of the best platforms. Vedantu has developed it themselves. Yeah, and also in this, you will get the access to classes of master teachers, experienced and qualified teachers. Yes, you will have class teachers in the classes, which will who will help you solve your doubts as well, real time. So you'll have the main teacher teaching, class teacher will be solving your doubts, so on and so forth. So all the benefits that you get in a coaching institute, you'll get study material, tests, assignments, etc., everything that you need straight away will be given to you. So you can check out the link. This is the coupon code. You can check out the prices by opening the link itself. Chalo ji. Now is the time for us to understand a bunch of things and derive a bunch of things about adiabatic processes. Yeah. So let us read what it is. Adiabatic process is the thermodynamic process in which heat exchange between system and surrounding is zero. All right. That is called an adiabatic process. Q value is equal to zero. So we know that delta U is equal to Q plus W, but Q is zero. So you simply have delta U is equal to W, or I can write a differential form as du is equal to dW. So my dear friends, what can I write over here? What can I write over here? I can write delta U is equal to minus PdV's integral. Depends on what information is given to you inside the question, isn't it? Ye likh sakta hun. I can also write this is equal to ncvdt. Do you remember that? Yeah, shouldn't write dt over here, should write delta t. Yes, can I write this? Delta U is equal to integral P dV is equal to NCV delta T. Since we are dealing with dV over here, let's try to convert this entire thing into a differential form. Okay, let's write dU. dU, tiny change in process, is equal to minus P dV. This is dW. Okay, so dW is equal to dU is equal to minus P dV is equal to NCV dT. Assuming that the number of moles doesn't change in the entire process. So dU equal to NCV dT, as I told you, is a universal formula because internal energy is a state function. And this is also a universal formula for work done. So I can write minus P dV is equal to NCV dT. One weird thing over here is that this pressure is supposed to be P external. Isn't it? That's how we define work done. Work is always done under the influence of the external pressure. You either get compressed against external pressure or you expand opposite to the external pressure. Yeah. So yahan pe pressure jo hoga, external hoga. So this right now is a very vague equation because one of the terms in this equation depends on the external circumstances. Yeah. We have no idea how to relate dt, dvp, because this is a universal idea. Okay. This thing that I've written in the box, this is universal. It is applicable to any system. It doesn't need to be a reversible system. It doesn't need to be an ideal gas. This formula is applicable anywhere. irreversible process, non-ideal gas, real gas, solid, liquid, whatever. This is a universal formula. But now we need to find an easier formula. Yeah, because that's what we always do. We try to define all of these things for ideal processes, ideal processes and reversible processes. तो क्या करते हैं, लेट्स ट्राई टू टेक दिस टू द नेक्स्ट पेज. ठीक है, अगले पेज पे लेके जाते हैं. नाउ इज द टाइम फॉर सम डेरिवेशन एंड दिस इज गोना बी रियली फन, लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ फन. ठीक है, आराम आराम से करेंगे स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो व्हाट आर वी डूइंग, वी आर डीलिंग विद एन एडियाबैटिक प्रोसेस, सो विच इंप्लाइज क्यू इज इक्वल टू जीरो. नाउ माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, टू कंडीशंस दैट आई विल एड अंडर एडियाबैटिक प्रोसेसेस. नंबर वन, दिस इज गोइंग टू बी अ रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस. And number two, this is going to be only for an ideal gas. Again, simplifying things so that we can derive a formula which we can use in questions, which we can use around us, and its result will be closer to the real condition. That's what ideal is, right? Ideal pe calculation karna easy hota hai. Result kafi similar hota hai real se. Sorry, my nose is always a little blocked. So, adiabatic process, reversible, ideal gas. So, what was the condition that we wrote on the previous page? What was the universal thing? I wrote minus. Yeah, let's just write the differential form now. This integral PdV, okay? This integral PV is equal to total work done. But if I'm talking about very small amount of work done, okay? If this is your pressure, this is your volume. This is your pressure, this is your volume. And this is the graph, let's say. So, integral minus PdV is basically the entire area under the curve. But if I am coming to dW, that is a very small part, or a small part over here, let's say. In this small part, in this tiny region, can I assume pressure is a constant value? In this tiny part, that is what integration is, right? In basic mathematics classes for physics and in integration, I'm pretty sure you've learned these ideas. How do you integrate? You assume tiny, tiny rectangles where the y-axis is a constant value and add them up. So over here, I simply need to write dW is equal to dU is equal to minus PdV is equal to nCV dT. Over here, pressure is external. Fine. So this is something that I can write. This is the proper way of writing the differential form of this particular idea for an adiabatic process. Now, my dear friends, as soon as I talk about an ideal gas and a reversible process, yeah, since it is reversible, please write this down. This derivation can come in your school exams as well for like 5 marks, but that is not worried about that. I'm worried about you guys enjoying the entire process of this derivation, and the formula at the end is very important. So, reversible process hai. Therefore, I can say I live right next to a highway, so you can expect some random noises of traffic. So, P external will be equal to P internal because it's a reversible process. What is the criteria behind a reversible process? It's a quasi-static process. The external conditions are always at equilibrium with the internal conditions, isn't it? Hai na? Mante ho ki nahi? Bilkul. Yes. So the thing is, over here, it's a reversible process. Therefore, P external is equal to P internal. This is one assumption. Since we are talking about an ideal gas now, do you realize I can simply write PV is equal to nRT? मजे हो गए यहां पे. सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, यूजिंग दीज टू आइडियाज आई विल मॉडिफाई दिस इक्वेशन अ लिटिल. आई कैन राइट इट एज माइनस पी इंटरनल डीवी इज इक्वल टू एन सीवी डीटी. वेरी नाइस, इजंट इट? ये तो मजेदार चीज हो गई, अब काफी अच्छी चीज हो गई. सो नाउ माइनस पी इंटरनल डीवी एन सीवी डीटी. If I turn pressure in terms of volume and temperature, then I can maybe solve this equation. Yeah, I have dV and I have dT. I need variables in terms of pressure, in terms of volume and temperature. Let's take out pressure from here. Pressure for a gas is equal to nRT by V. Pressure for a gas is equal to nRT by V. So I can write this as minus nRT by V into dV is equal to
NCV dt.
ये आ गया. प्लीज राइट थिंग्स डाउन अंटिल दिस पॉइंट. ओके, एक बार इस पॉइंट तक लिख लीजिए आप. जस्ट टिल दैट पॉइंट राइट दिस आइडिया डाउन. ओके चलो, नाउ आई एम गोना इरेज द रेस्ट ऑफ द पेज. आई विल यूज द थिंग दैट आई हैव ओवर हियर एट द बॉटम जस्ट टू डू सम कैलकुलेशंस फॉर यू. वी विल यूज द थिंग दैट वी हैव रिटन एट द बॉटम. यस फाइन. So, let's take this. I'm going to rewrite this in a better manner so that I can easily solve it. I'm going to write it as N R dV by V, over here you have a minus sign, is equal to N CV dT by T. I just took T on the right hand side, dV by V, dT by T, minus sign over here. Let's cancel out the N. NN can cancel out, right? Why are we writing N? Let's forget about it. So I have minus R dV by V is equal to CV dT by T. And CV, what is CV? CV is degrees of freedom by 2 into R. We'll use that information. Okay. We will use that information eventually. So ab kya karein? Isko integrate karte hain yaar. Let's try to integrate this thing. Okay. So what can I say? What can I do over here? Integrate kaise karein? So minus R, simply integral dalte hain. And let's integrate it in a definite fashion, not in an indefinite fashion, because then you will have the constant of integration. We'll deal with that. So let's start from V1, go to V2. V1 corresponds to T1 and we go to T2. Yes. So on the left hand side, can I write after integration, it will be minus R ln of V2 by V1. Basically, you will have ln of V2. Yeah, minus ln of V1. ये होगा. एंड यू नो द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ln r. यू कैन सिंपली राइट माइनस r ln ऑफ v2 बाय v1. इजंट इट? लिख सकता हूं मैं. ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड आई कैन राइट cv ln ऑफ t2 बाय t1. इजंट इट? ये लिख सकता हूं मैं. दिस इज गोइंग समवेयर. दिस इज गेटिंग टू अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल प्लेस. वी विल सी वेयर. बट माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग cv, इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग r, my request to you is, instead of trying to denote it in R and CV, let's try to denote it with gamma. Somehow, let us try to replace R and CV with gamma. कैसे करें? R और CV को क्या करना है? Replace करना है gamma से. Why do we have to do it? Because it will give us a very beautiful equation at the end of the day. I will tell you, don't worry. But for now, the exercise is, let us try to replace this R and CV by gamma. You know CV by R is degrees of freedom by 2, isn't it? थोड़ा सोच के देखते हैं. Okay, let's try to think about it. Gamma is equal to CP by CV. Yes. So over here, can I say gamma is equal to degrees of freedom divided by degrees of freedom plus 2? सॉरी, उल्टा लिख गया ना मैं. कैन आई से डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम डिवाइडेड बाय डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम प्लस 2? डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम प्लस 2 डिवाइडेड बाय डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम. कैन आई से दैट? व्हाई डू आई से दैट? ये क्यों लिखा मैंने? लेट मी रिमाइंड यू. सीवी इज इक्वल टू डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम बाय 2 इनटू आर. यस. एंड सिमिलरली सीपी इज इक्वल टू डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम by 2 plus degrees of freedom by 2 r plus r. You have to add another r over here. So can I write degree of freedom plus 2 by 2 r? Yeah, degree of freedom by 2 r is CV and 2 by 2 r is r. So do you understand this idea? This is something that we have discussed in the previous class, so please don't forget it. So my dear friends, over there, what have I written? I have written gamma is equal to degree of freedom plus 2 divided by degree of freedom, which is simply CP by CV. That is something that we understand. Now, what can I write from here? Can I write CV by R as something? यहीं से लिख लेते हैं यार. CV by R is equal to degree of freedom divided by 2. Yes, CV by R is equal to degree of freedom divided by 2. let's make it an opposite. Okay, wherever we are going, you'll understand later. I'm just doing some mathematical manipulations over here. Can I write R by CV is equal to 2 divided by degrees of freedom? Can I write this? How do I make that now? इससे ये कैसे बनाऊं? My dear friends, do you realize? If I add one on both sides, let us add one on both sides. R by CV plus 1 is equal to 2 by degrees of freedom plus 1. Just put it inside the equation. What will you get? You will get 2 plus degree of freedom. What is this equal to? This is equal to gamma. What were we trying to do? We were trying to find a relationship between R, CV and gamma. Gamma is equal to degree of freedom plus 2 by degree of freedom. CV by R is equal to degree of freedom by 2. Manipulated it a little and we got this particular relation. So, what's the final relation that we will be using over here? We'll be using this very important relation over here, that R by CV is equal to gamma minus 1. Fine. Just some manipulation that we've done. Gamma is CP by CV. Gamma can be written as degree of freedom by degree of freedom plus 2 by degree of freedom. CV by R is equal to degree of freedom by 2. So just add 1 after inversion and you will get this particular funda. So R by CV is equal to gamma minus 1. Okay, we will use this now. We will use this particular idea over here. So can I write this as minus R by CV ln V2 by V1 is equal to ln of T2 by T1? I can write this, isn't it? The truck is happy that we've reached this point of derivation. Now people, what can I write this as? R by CV is gamma minus 1. Minus R by CV will be 1 minus gamma. Minus of R by CV will be 1 minus gamma. Now, there is a coefficient that is multiplied to the log. Do you realize I can take it inside as a power? These are properties of log. If you don't remember properties of log, don't worry. You can watch a video on YouTube later on properties of log. What happens is, I'll try to elaborate over here. Okay, ln is basically the natural log. Ln is log to the base of e. These are mathematical functions. I'm pretty sure you've studied something about them in sets, relations and functions in mathematics. Okay, so this is a property. X ln y is equal to ln of y raised to the power x. This is a property of the log function. Okay, so there's nothing to worry about what this is. So isse kya karenge apan? What will we do now? I'm going to take this inside. I will write this as the power of V2 by V1. Kya tha yahan pe? 1 minus gamma. Yes. So ln of V2 by V1 raised to the power 1 minus gamma is equal to ln of T2 by T1. So what will I do over here? I will just cancel the ln basically. Whatever is inside the ln now, it is equal, right? Ln x is equal to ln y implies x is equal to y. So this is the equation that we'll use right now. I'm going to erase everything. You can pause this video anywhere. Isko erase karte hain. We've already spent enough time with this on the screen. Chalo ji. So yahan se kya jayega? V2 to the power 1 minus gamma upon V1 to the power 1 minus gamma is equal to T2 by T1. Let's rearrange this a little. I can write it as T1. Sorry, isko thoda ulta karke likhte hain. Yeah, this is T2 by T1, right? Let me take T1 here. Let me take V2 there. So what I will do is I will erase this and write T1 over here. Yahan pe aa gaya T1 and volume factor which was there I have taken over here, which is V2 raised to the power 1 minus gamma. My dear friends, now if I have to take this upwards, what will I do? Power ulta ho jayega. Do you understand? If I want to take this up, power will become negative. You understand, right? 1 by v to the power x is equal to v to the power minus x. Do you understand? 1 by v to the power x is equal to v to the power minus x. So I'm going to manipulate this equation a little bit more. T1 into v1 to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to T2 into v2 to the power gamma minus 1. My dear friends, this particular result can be generalized a little. This particular result can be generalized a little, and I can write TV into gamma minus 1. TV raised to the power gamma minus 1 is a constant value. What is this constant? Doesn't matter. Okay. What is this constant? Doesn't matter. For different processes, it will be a different constant. Yeah. So, uski chinta karne ki zarurat nahi hai. The only thing that you have to remember, TV to the power gamma minus 1 is a constant value. How did we start the derivation? Let me recap it for you. We started the derivation by writing dW is equal to dU minus PdV is equal to nCV dt. Put the assumptions of reversible processes, P internal and P external are equal. So we now have P internal, and that P internal can be replaced by nRT by V because of the ideal gas equation. Integrated on both sides, and till now we've just been doing some mathematical here and there. Yeah, R by CV ko gamma minus 1 likh diya, ln kaat diya, took the power inside, took the power upstairs, etc. Just mathematical manipulations, and we get a result TV to the power gamma minus 1 is a constant. This result can be extrapolated furthermore. We'll use this part and we'll write a few more things. I'm erasing everything else. You can pause the video any way you want, by the way. And we are going to use this particular result to go forward a little. So my dear friends, over here you know that PV is equal to nRT because we are discussing things about an ideal gas. Let us try to remove temperature from here. Let us try to put pressure. I now want a relationship between pressure and volume. Okay, I now want a relationship between pressure and volume. So look at what I will do. I have TV to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. Whatever this constant is, I'm calling it a K right now. Okay, random constant. There is no specific name for this constant. It's K. Instead of T, can I write PV by NR? From here, I can write T is equal to PV by NR. I'll write that over here. So T ki jagah main likhunga PV by NR into V to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. My dear friends, do you realize that NR is also a constant value? Let's take NR to the right hand side. NR ko yahan se hatayenge and we'll take it over here. Do you realize this particular term is still a constant value? As I said, whatever is the constant doesn't matter. Yeah, we'll always have to compare P1, V1 to P2, V2 to P3, V3. Constant doesn't matter. We'll be comparing initial conditions to final conditions. Fine. So, yahan pe, given this idea, do you realize this thing is also a constant? And V into V to the power gamma minus 1 will be equal to V to the power gamma minus 1 into V. Kya hoga? It'll be as good as V to the power gamma minus 1 plus 1. Because you're multiplying one more gamma, V to the power 1, add kar rahe ho aap isme. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Y to the power A into Y to the power B is equal to Y to the power A plus B. Yeah, so V to the power 1 into V to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to V to the power 1 plus gamma minus 1. That is equal to V to the power gamma. Understood? So, yahan pe kya likhenge apan? This can be written as P into V to the power gamma, and that is a constant value. Don't worry about what this constant is. It's just that this is a constant value. My dear friends, what we have derived right now is one of the most important things about adiabatic reversible processes for an ideal gas. This particular result is very, very, very important. PV to power gamma is a constant for an adiabatic reversible process for an ideal gas. P PV to the power gamma is a constant. You can also write it as TV to the power gamma minus 1 is a constant. A little homework for you. Okay, a little homework for you. This is a very simple thing that you can do. The class is not over, by the way. Just giving you a mid-class homework. Find relation between pressure and temperature. Same thing like this. Same thing. Right now we have P into V to the power gamma constant. T into V to the power gamma minus 1 is a constant. So you need to find out P to the power something, T to the power something is a constant. That is what you have to find out. That is what you have to report as the answer in the comment section down below. It's a very simple calculation, yes? All you need to do is take this equation, instead of volume, put a term of pressure. Or you can take this equation, put a term of temperature over here. Theek hai? So use either one of these equations and the ideal gas equation to find a relationship between P and T. Got it? This is what you have to do. Chalo ji. So PV to the power gamma is a constant, and that is applicable for an ideal gas reversible adiabatic process. Nice. So this result we will keep on using eventually. We will use this result quite extensively in the upcoming classes. Yeah. But right now it's the time for us to deal with a process that is not reversible. Okay, we'll deal with an irreversible process. So yahan pe answer hi dikh gaya aapko. Anyway, I'll quickly move the slide away. That was just the summary of the adiabatic processes. Answer dikhi gaya hoga aapko. Fir bhi, try to do it yourself and give it to me in the chat box later. Chalo. What will be the work done if an ideal gas sample is compressed from 1 atm 10 liter to 5 atm 2 liter isothermally and irreversibly? We already know a formula for isothermal work done, reversible case. Since work done is a path function, work done depends on the path taken, you cannot use that same formula to define work done for an irreversible process. Yes. So what we need to do over here is, we need to figure out the process. We need to figure out how this process is happening. You have to pay a lot of attention over here, because there will be a few assumptions that we will make. Even for irreversible processes, we have to make some assumption. My dear friends, do you understand? If I make a PV curve, let us make the initial state and the final state. Okay. Initial state is 1 atm. Sorry for the noises. Initial state is 1 atm 10 liter. So let's say this is your 1 atm. 1 atm, so yahan pe aayega, let's say this is your 10 liters. Okay, so this is your initial state. This is your initial state. Okay, yahan pe main likh dunga INI, that refers to initial. Now, what is the final state? Final state is 5 atm 2 liter. I have increased the pressure. So let's say this is your 5 atm. Okay, and 2 liter is, let's say, somewhere here. So final state is this one. So yahan pe main likh dunga final. What we have to do is, we have to go from this state via an irreversible process. Now, irreversible process could be any type of process, right? It could be this process. Pretty much, if it is a fast process, it is irreversible. We know what a reversible process looks like. Reversible process mein, your P into V will always be a constant value. Yeah, in a reversible process, pressure external is pressure internal, temperature is going to be conserved, so your PV will always be a constant value, like your Charles law. So this is your reversible graph, Charles law basically. Yeah, do you remember, this is something that we kaun sa hota wo sabse pehle wala, Boyle's law. Yeah, Boyle's law mein pressure into volume is a constant value because temperature is not changing. So this is what is applicable for a reversible process, because at each point the system is well defined. But if the system is not well defined, if it's an irreversible process, if it's a fast process, I don't know what the path is. Do you realize that the path could be anything? It could be this path, it could be this path, it could be this path, it could be a straight path as well. So right now, whenever such a question comes, whenever a question of an irreversible process comes to you, you have to make a choice.
Okay, you have to make an informed decision over here.
What is that choice? Let me try to tell that to you. What you have to assume is, what is this choice? In this choice, the first thing that you have to assume is pressure changes suddenly. To make this irreversible process happen, what you have to do is change the pressure suddenly. Ekdam se pressure change. Initially it was 1 atm, you suddenly make it 5 atm. Okay? So what are we saying? Initially pressure was 1 atm, you suddenly make it 5 atm. This is what the first point means. This is, we are making a choice. We are choosing this specific irreversible path. This is what you have to choose in questions. Okay? This specific path has to be chosen in your questions as well. So what is the path that we've chosen? We've chosen that the pressure changes suddenly. Ekdam se yahan se chala gaya. Fatafat se. Okay? No curve whatsoever. Straight away it goes to 5 atm pressure. Cool. Second thing. Then volume changes accordingly. See, overall, this process is isothermal. Irreversible, as the path is not a well-defined path. During the path, if it is isothermal or not, you don't care about it. Initial and final points have to be at the same temperature. Reversible ke case mein, every point has to be at same temperature. Irreversible ke case mein, only initial and final points need to be at same temperature in an isothermal process. Yeah. Sorry. तो क्या मतलब है मेरा? Suddenly we change the pressure and then volume will change accordingly. This is our process. It starts from here, goes here. Why did we choose this process? Because again, it is easy to do the calculation. If we chose a very random irreversible process, how would we do the calculation? No point of doing that yet. So this is a choice that we have to make whenever there's a question on irreversible processes. This is the choice we have to make. You change the pressure suddenly and then change the volume accordingly. So pressure change suddenly and then the volume changes accordingly. Fine. So now, my dear friends, in this particular graph, what will be the work done? That's what we have to calculate, right? Yeah, we have to figure out the work done. So work done will be, equal to minus P external delta V. This is our P external now. We have kept in our mind, this is the choice that we made, that we suddenly raise the external pressure to 5 atm. So the pressure of the gas increases and then the volume decreases suddenly. Yeah. So ye choice apan ne rakha. Work is equal to minus P external delta V. This is equal to minus into 5 atm into volume final minus initial. Final volume is 2 liter. Initial volume is 10 liter. So my dear friends, this comes out to be kitna aa jata hai? 5 into 8. Yeah, this is 40 liter atm. Work done over here is 40 liter atm. Fine. Suddenly change the pressure, then change the volume accordingly. 40 liter atm of work is done. Now let us try to change this question slightly. Slightly, I'm going to change this question. What I will do is, I will do this change. So this is your initial point right now, and this is your final point eventually. This is your initial point, this is your final point. So let's try to make that graph once again, and let's make that choice of the irreversible process that makes sense to us. Fine. So ye raha 1 atm, this is your 5 atm, this is your 2 liter, this is your 10 liter, and this is your initial point, 5 liter 2 atm, this is your initial point, and this is your final point, 1 liter 10 atm. Yes, you want me to make dotted lines? Okay, just for some beautification. Now we will start from 5 atm. Yes, अपन 5 atm 2 liter से start कर रहे हैं. You have to take it to 1 atm 10 liter. What was the first choice? First choice was to change the pressure suddenly. How do I change the pressure suddenly? From 5 atm to 1 atm, you change the pressure suddenly, and then the volume changes accordingly. Suddenly, accordingly. Pressure changes suddenly, volume changes accordingly. Answer to this question will be this area. Answer to this question will be this area. So W is equal to minus P external delta V. Now P external V suddenly changed it to 1 atm. Delta V is 10 minus 2. Yeah, final minus initial. So this comes out to be minus 8 liter atm work done. Can you see? If this was a reversible process, the curve would be like this. You would go towards this state on the same curve. You will come back to the initial state on the same curve. So if you go from here to here, work done is positive sign. If you go from here to here, work done is negative sign. But the magnitude of work done will be the same in both cases, whether you go from here to here or here to here. That's the beauty of a reversible process. That's why we call it reversible. Yes. That's the point of a reversible process, that the path can be retraced. But over here, see, for compression, we were doing 40 liter atm of work. For expansion, only 8 liter atm of work is done by the system. This is the beauty of irreversible processes. Can't be traced back. That's why we call it irreversible. And this is the kind of irreversible process that we have to choose. AISA. Okay. A lot of you must be thinking, sir, can't we choose an irreversible process that traces its path back? Then it won't be an irreversible process. Do you understand? Theoretically, that becomes a reversible process. Practically speaking, that is not possible. Practically speaking as well, this is how most irreversible processes will happen. The changes will be sudden. Okay. So this is a very good assumption of an irreversible process. Changes will be sudden. Chalo ji, ye ho gaya. Nice. So now people, what we need to do is we need to compare a few things. We need to compare the magnitudes of work, compression, irreversible. We have to compare this with work, reversible. Okay, only magnitudes. That's why I'm putting the modulus sign around them. Only the magnitudes. Work compressible, irreversible, work reversible, and then work expansion, irreversible. All right. How do we do that? Again, let's just make a graph. Let us say, and we are talking about isothermal processes. Okay, all of these processes are isothermal in nature. P1 into V1 is equal to P2 into V2 for initial and final states. P1 V1 equal to P2 V2 for all states in reversible. Chalo. So let's say this is your initial point and this is your final point. Let's not call it initial final. Let's call it A point, B point. Let's call it A. Let's call it B. So people, if we are at A and we have to do expansion, what will be the graph? For A to go to B, the expansion will be suddenly drop the pressure and the volume will expand. This red colored work done, is work for an irreversible expansion, right? Now I'm going to use the blue color. I know it's not very visible. Kahan chala gaya? It's not very visible, but still. So if I do a reversible process, this is what it will be. You go in any direction. This will be your reversible process. Yeah. Rectangular hyperbola. So work done for the reversible process will be this much. So this blue colored work done is your work reversible isothermal expansion or compression. Again, we are dealing just with the magnitude. And finally, I'm using the green pen now for starting from B. Okay, we are starting from point B. Let me just complete this red color part and the blue color part as well, so that it looks proper and neat. Okay. So now,
we are trying to go from this point back to point A. We are causing compression. Yeah, we are taking it from a higher volume to a lower volume. So what will we do? We'll suddenly increase the pressure and then we will decrease the volume. So in case of compression, this is the entire work done. Yeah, now this looks like modern art, but I'm pretty sure you guys understand. So this is your work. Compression, irreversible, isothermal. So my dear friends, over here, do you notice that the magnitude of work done in the compression case is the highest compared to the reversible expansion or compression, compared to the irreversible compression or expansion. This is applicable for isothermal cases. This particular result is very important. Direct qualitative questions come from this part. Please make sure you write it down. Very, very important. Kuch zyada hi zaruri hai. Theek hai? So isko please note kar lo yaar. Work compression irreversible is greater than work reversible is greater than work expansion irreversible. Yeah, so work compression irreversible, work reversible, work expansion irreversible for isothermal. These are the orders of their magnitudes. We're not talking about the sign, we're just talking about the magnitude of work. Fine, so please remember this idea. This will be useful later on. Cool, done, badhiya. All right, chalo. Now, my dear friends, the next thing that I have to ask you, okay, so ye humne kar liya, isothermal reversible versus irreversible work done. We just did that graph, very nice. Now, the next thing that I want to ask you is very, very interesting. This is going to be a thought experiment essentially. We are going to think about it qualitatively, not quantitatively. Bhavna samjhenge iski, number ki koi zarurat nahi hai idhar. Theek hai? Let's try to do this, and this is the final thing that we will discuss in today's class. Starting from state A, P1, V1, T1. State B, P2, V2, T2 is achieved via a reversible adiabatic process. अच्छा ठीक है, तो क्या किया अपन ने? We are starting from this particular point. This is again pressure, this is again volume, and this is an adiabatic process. Again, what we can assume over here is ideal gas. ठीक है, तो assume ideal gas. Assume ideal gas. So by assuming ideal gas, what I have done is, okay, for a reversible process, for an ideal gas, I can say PV to the power gamma is a constant value. Yeah, I can say PV to the power gamma is a constant value. So if you figure out what the graph looks like, I'll tell it to you. The graph will look like an isothermal graph, but a little more steep. Similar to an isothermal graph, but this will have a steeper slope. Yeah, thoda jyada jaldi se girega. Something like that. We'll compare adiabatic and isothermal in the next class, don't worry. Next class will be on Tuesday at 7. We'll do that comparison properly. But right now, this is what your reversible graph looks like for an ideal gas. Because over here, PV to the power gamma is a constant. So this is point A. This is P1, V1, T1. This is point B, P2, V2, T2. This is your point A. This is your point B. So it is said, it is given in the question that I can reach from point A to point B via a reversible adiabatic process. Now, the question is, can state B be achieved? Can I achieve state B starting from A via an irreversible adiabatic process? Is it possible for me to do an adiabatic process that is irreversible, start from A and go to point B? Sorry. Soch ke dekhe. Let's try to think about it. This is just a thought experiment. Okay. This is just a thought experiment. The answer is either yes or no. So my dear friends, for adiabatic processes, can I write delta W is equal to delta U, or simply write W is equal to delta U? Isn't it? Assume it can be done. Assume it can be done. Assume करके देखते हैं. हाँ चलो मान लिया. Assume it can be done. Yeah. If we assume it can be done, the thing is, delta U for reversible will be equal to delta U for irreversible. Do you agree?
Why? Because delta U, because internal energy is a state function. If you are coming from state A to state B, no matter how you are coming, change in internal energy will be the same. It's like displacement. I'm standing here, I go around the world and come here, my displacement is zero. I might have traveled huge distances, yeah? So over here, once again, what's going on? If it can be done, if I can reach from state A to state B via reversible and irreversible adiabatic process both, my internal energies will be the same. But do you realize work done for a reversible path can never be equal to work done for an irreversible path? Do you understand? Work done for a reversible path can never be equal to an irreversible path. Soch ke dekh lo na. This is the reversible path. This cannot be the irreversible path. Irreversible path will be somewhere here or here or here or whatever. If we are thinking about the same kind of irreversible path, okay? Aisa kuch karna chahenge apan. That is what we will try to do. But again, if you say, sir, yes, I can do this. The thing is that this will not be an adiabatic process. In an adiabatic process, you have to make sure that heat exchange is zero. That is why I can write W is equal to delta U. Hai na? Adiabatic hai, tabhi to ye likh sakta hun. Agar ye true hi nahi hoga, to main kuch kar hi nahi sakta na process. So this process, there will be some heat exchange over there. Forget about this guy. Okay? That is the question now. Can we make an irreversible process to go from A to B, which is again adiabatic? There could be some other type of irreversible process. I am not saying that. Yeah, let me make this curve again. Thoda ganda kar diya maine. From A to B, there can be some other irreversible process, but can that irreversible process be adiabatic? If it is adiabatic, W is equal to delta U reversible is equal to delta U irreversible, obviously, but we know that W reversible is not equal to W irreversible. This implies delta U reversible is not equal to delta U irreversible. Hence, this assumption is wrong. Therefore, I cannot do this. If you have a curve which represents reversible adiabatic process for an ideal gas, an irreversible process cannot be coinciding with that. Okay? If you start with a reversible process over here, irreversible adiabatic process might go somewhere else, but it will never coincide once again. Is particular graph ke saath dubara irreversible process kabhi milega hi nahi. Starting point can be the same, but they will never converge. I mean, they will never intersect again. Theek hai? It's just a little high level thought. Think about it once again. To kya apan ne assume kiya? Just summarizing this for you. We said that, okay, if both processes are adiabatic, in both processes, W is equal to delta U. And delta U reversible will be delta U irreversible because the initial and final state are the same. But since delta U is equal to W, since delta U is equal to a path function over here, path function will never be the same for two different paths. W reversible will never be equal to W irreversible. So the thing is that if I start from the same point, reversible curve and irreversible curve will never intersect again. Iska aur iska milap dubara kabhi ho hi nahi sakta. If you start from this point and start doing an irreversible adiabatic process, you can never reach this particular point which has been reached by a reversible adiabatic process. Nice question. Yeah. Alright people, so this was the final discussion for today's class. So I've already given you your homework. You have to give me the relationship between temperature and volume for an adiabatic process, which is reversible for an ideal gas. Too much to say. Okay? So this is also one question. This is an easy question, by the way. Isme koi badi mushkil cheez nahi hai. So this is also your do-it-yourself question. You can do it if you want to answer it in the comments. You can. Don't need to answer. That's also fine. So this is a do-it-yourself question. Very basic, okay? This is from the concepts that we discussed in the last to last class. So people, that's it for today's class. All right. In case you want to join Vedanta as a long-term student, please join the pro subscription. The link is in the description box down below. It's called vdnt.in/ytpro. PH Pro is the coupon code for your discount. All right. So this was a premiered class. I hope you still enjoyed it. If you have any doubts, leave it in the comment section down below. Stay subscribed. Hit that like button if you enjoyed the class. I will tell you that the next class of thermodynamics is on Tuesday at 7 p.m. So we will be comparing isothermal processes with adiabatic processes, their reversible processes, their irreversible processes, etc. We'll try to do some questions of work done in these different processes. Then from the next class onwards, which is on Thursday at 7 p.m., coming Thursday at 7 p.m., we will start with free expansion and we'll discuss the second law of thermodynamics. A couple of days will go in the second law of thermodynamics, and then we will start thermochemistry, where we will discuss different types of enthalpies. We will discuss Hess law, we'll do questions of Hess law, and that will be our chapter. So at least 2 more weeks for thermodynamics. Yeah, so as I already predicted, September, almost all of it will go into thermodynamics. Then we'll go into chemical equilibrium, then ionic equilibrium. For all of you who want to learn GOC, general organic chemistry, you simply search for Epic GOC on YouTube. Okay, this is a series of videos that I have made on Vedantu JEE channel. You watch it. This is the best series on GOC that you can ever get. Fine. So people, I hope you enjoyed this. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Stay subscribed. I'll see you very soon. Take care.